Hello everyone, myself Siddharth and I welcome you all to my YouTube channel. Today, I am going to share important information related to LLM entrance examination conducted by the South Asian University. In this video, I will be discussing about the university, entrance examination structure, LLM syllabus, study materials and other crucial tips based on my experience. So watch the video till the end. Also, if you are not appearing for LLM but for some other courses at SAU, this video would still be helpful for you to provide a broad overview of the university and its entrance examination. Before moving further, please hit the like and subscribe button for more related contents. Done. So when you are preparing for SAU entrance exam, it's important to know about the university. After all, you will be spending your 2 years here. SAU is an international university jointly established by SAARC member states including Afghanistan, Bangladesh, Bhutan, India, Maldives, Nepal, Pakistan, and Sri Lanka. It offers postgraduate and doctoral programs in various disciplines. For admission to master's and PhD programs in economics, sociology, IR, and legal studies, the minimum prescribed eligibility criteria is 50 marks or an equivalent grade in the qualifying degree. For the other three programs, that are applied mathematics, biotechnology, and computer science, the minimum eligibility percentage is 55% or an equivalent grade in the qualifying degree. SAU offers you a 2-year full-time LLM program with an emphasis on international law. LLM and all other master's program will have total 30 seats, out of which 15 seats are for Indian candidates and 15 are for students from other SAARC member states. Candidates seeking admission to these courses have to undertake an entrance test. And based upon a merit list, they are inducted into their respective programs. You can visit and read more about the university. I have provided the SAU website link in the description below. SAU LLM entrance test syllabus will have two parts. The first part deals with a general segment. It talks about GK, where you need to prepare basic history, including world history events, basic geography, scientific and other developments. You need to know current affairs, emphasizing on all recent happenings and important events in the South Asia. Also, you should have a basic knowledge of SAARC, South Asia and other international organizations. Out of 100 questions, 20 questions will be asked from this part. The rest of the part includes law subjects. 80 questions are asked from this law segment. You should follow the syllabus provided on the SAU website. Some of the important subjects in this category are public international law. Here, you need to prepare fundamental topics in international law. For example, sources of international law. I would suggest while reading sources of international law, you should thoroughly go through customs, treaties and various other international agreements and developments related to these sources of international law. Next will be relationship between domestic and international law, law of the seas, extradition, asylum. So these are a few topics that you need to focus. While talking about international organizations, you need to study UN Charter, particularly Article 1, 2 and other articles that talk about various organs of United Nations. Also, read leading and recent cases held by ICJ and other tribunals. These are some important topics that should be covered for public international law and international organizations. Next is jurisprudence. Here you should definitely cover topics like schools of jurisprudence, theories given by famous jurists, legal personality, Hawfield Square. Next is environmental law and biodiversity protection law. You should study environmental principles like precautionary principle, polluter pays principle, no transboundary harm principle, and other environmental law cases. Also refer to important agreements and conferences in international law sphere, including Stockholm Declaration 1972, Rio Declaration 1992, Kyoto Protocol, UNCBD, UNFCCC, UNCCD, Montreal Protocol on Ozone, Basel Convention on Hazardous Waste, and 2015 Sustainable Development Goals, to name a few. Next, you should focus on human rights and refugee law, where important topics are Universal Declaration of Human Rights, 1948, ICCPR and ICESCR, 1966, CEDAW for Women, CERD, 1969, that deals with elimination of racial discrimination. For humanitarian law, prepare Geneva Convention 1949. Also go through its historical developments. Likewise, in international criminal law, study about war crime, genocide, crime against humanity, crime of aggression, Rome Convention, and International Criminal Court. Next is trade law. Here, you should study GATT 1994. You should also read leading WTO cases. For IPR, study various conventions concerning IPRs. Now, another big question: from where to study these topics for the entrance examination? I have made a list of sources you might consider for your preparation. For general category, you should start reading current affairs and general knowledge books, which are very commonly available anywhere. You should read newspaper and relevant magazine on regular basis. Also, you can refer to internet sources for general studies. For law segment, I would suggest you few books that you might consider for your preparation. For international law, you can go with Malcolm Shaw. For jurisprudence, there is a book, Edgar Bodenheimer, you can refer. For international environmental law, there is a book by Philip Sands and Jacqueline Peel. For IPR, a book by V.K. Ahuja. These are good books and can greatly help in developing your concepts. You can also refer to books like S.K. Kapoor for international law and human rights and S.R. Mainani for international trade law. If you have access to some other books, you can definitely go with them, but make sure they cover your syllabus. If you have well-prepared class notes from your law graduation that covers the SAU syllabus topics, then I will suggest you to start your preparation with them. They will help you to get yourself familiar with the contents. Now, coming to some tips for this examination. Well, what I have observed from the previous SAU entrance exams is that students should have a basic knowledge and understanding of international law subjects. Study fundamental topics. You need not to be the expert of international law. That you will become while studying at SAU. LLM at SAU emphasizes on international legal studies. While preparing for the entrance, focus more on the international part of subjects like environmental law or human rights. It will save your time. Talking about how much time is required for SAU preparation, in my opinion, about 3 to 4 months of preparation, provided that you have diligently attended your law graduation classes, can raise the chances of your selection in the exam. I should say the syllabus is vast and limited at the same time. SAU syllabus is very different from any other LLM program, and that makes it look huge and scattered. At the beginning, you might face difficulty to cover different aspects of the syllabus. But don't panic. The fact is, you have not appeared for this kind of exam before. With a consistent study and correct study materials, you will soon command the entire syllabus and develop the required aptitude to appear for this exam. So, to sum up, all you need is hard work and interest in these subjects. I hope you would have found this video relevant for your entrance exam. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section below. If you want me to make another video for PhD law admissions, then also let me know down there. Don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button before leaving. All the best for your exams.